Hello, and welcome to this 16th video in using Blender for video editing. In this session, we're going to talk about healthy vegetables. No, I'm just kidding. We're going to talk about the transform effects strip, which is just as good as healthy vegetables. So what can you do with the transform effects strip? Three things. Translation, which means moving things from side to side, up and down. Scaling, which means growing or shrinking something. And rotation. To demonstrate it, I am going to go through a use case, which is going to be setting up Pictureinpicture, like what I do for all of these tutorial videos, where I take the video recording of me talking, and I shrink it, and I move it into the corner. We're going to go through that with this example here. So as you can see, I've got two video strips right now. I have this one down here, which if I go across it, you can see it's just a video of a bird. And then I have this one here, which starts with healthy vegetables and quickly goes into a Cookie Monster. Now, to use the transform effect strip, it is like the transition effect strips that we saw before, the wipe and the gamma cross, where you have to select the video strip that you want to apply the transform to. Now, I want to take this top video strip and turn that into my picture within the picture. So I have it selected now using the right mouse button, and now I can go to Add, Effect Strip, Transform. If I zoom out, you can see that Blender has added a new strip on top of the source strip that I specified with the exact same length as the original source. And it's colored green so you can distinguish it easily from the rest. Now how do we actually use it? So, step one, we're going to shrink it, and then we're going to move it into the corner, and just for kicks, I guess we could rotate it as well. Actually, maybe we'll rotate first. Okay, let's do that. So I have it, it's already selected. I'm going to scroll down here and along the properties for the strip, and I'm gonna scroll down here to rotation. So it works in degrees, so if I wanted to flip it upside down, I could type 180. And there we go, now it's upside down. Or maybe I didn't want it. Let's actually do something else. Let's switch it to, let's make it sideways. Let's do 90 degrees. So I'll type 90, and now it's sideways. And now, the next thing, we're working backwards here. Now we're going to talk about scale. You can see here, I have got two different scale fields, X and Y, because Blender allows you to scale them separately if you wanted to. For me, I want to keep the aspect ratio the same. So, meaning if I were to set the X to 0.5, I want Y to be 0.5 as well. In that case, if you want to do something similar, just check this box, uniform scale. That way it removes the X and the Y and replaces with a single scale field that you can then change as you please. I'm just gonna click with my left mouse button and just drag along to get it to the size I want. Okay, I'll do that. So that's 31%. Again, that's percent there. That's not related to this. See, if I change that, that doesn't affect that. This is strictly on a percentage basis. Okay, and then last step, let's stick it in the corner. This time I'm going to put it in the top left. So now I can go up to translation unit. I had changed it. It was by default on percent. I'm just going to put it back there. And then I will just click and drag to the left to get it to move to roughly the left side with maybe a little bit of a gap. And then same thing with the Y. I'm gonna bring that up. And there you go. That's basically Pictureinpicture right there. As we saw before with when we worked with image offset and image crop, now, as soon as we shrunk it and then started moving it, we could see that Blender is now showing us this checkerboard background, which is its way of telling us that, well, there's nothing there now, so if we were to render this, it would be this small little sliver of Cookie Monster and everything else would be black. But what we want to do is a picture-in-picture. We want this video here to be seen above this video here. And to do that, we need to scroll up to the top of the properties and adjust this setting here, blend. Like we saw before, right now the default is replace. To allow everything else underneath to show through, you can pick overdrop, and that by doing so it now lets you see what's underneath. That's pretty much all there is to it. So if I just scrub on the timeline here, you can see that it's working pretty well. And that's how you can use the transform effect. There's one more thing I'd like to tell you about before we go. And it's not noticeable here, but sometimes as you add effects upon effects, you might run into this issue where the original source video strip that you started working with starts to show up underneath the effects. I see that sometimes when I have a video strip and then I have a speed control, which we'll talk about later, and then this transform, I find that things are actually still showing when I'm not expecting them to. So to prevent that from ever happening, as a general rule of thumb, what I would suggest you to do is go back to the original video strip you had, and near the top there, this little icon of an eye, just click on that. And that pretty much hides that strip from view, so it won't be seen again. So you don't want to get rid of it, because the transform effect strip is basically relying on this original strip. But you want to just hide it, so it's not going to interfere with anything. So there you have it, the transform effect. That's it for this session. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye now.